Welcome to Introduction to Teamwork Part 2, which is about product management in teams. So a product is characterized by a unique task, and it includes many complex activities and therefore also many requests. Many product group members which have different skills and different competences. The product is goal-oriented, so there is a goal in the end. It's limited in time and resources, so a limited amount of time and limited amount of people. And it has to produce a final result, which is also the goal. So this is true for many projects in companies and also for the student projects in EPIC and many other student projects. The product management consists of two parts. There is the management of people and there is the management of time and other resources. Looking at the time management, we will do in a later presentation. So here I will focus on the people. So what is really the most important advice is to make a team charter, a code of conduct, a collaboration agreement, call it what you want, but to write down explicitly in order to create the common expectations and to secure clear agreements. Securing clear agreements means that it's clear what is expected from you, and it's also clear when someone is breaking the expectations and the agreements, and then you can address it. If you don't write it down, if you don't make it explicit, then you just get annoyed by other people not doing what you think they should do. But that's very hard to blame them unless it's something that you have actually clearly agreed upon. So the form can be a contract with the supervisor to have a good collaboration with the supervisor and make sure that you have aligned expectations between the group and the supervisor, but also have to have contracts within the groups. So task strategies, process strategies. What it should contain is something about expectations and ambitions. For example, do you want to get the A grade, the highest grade? Are you happy if you're just passing? How much time do you actually plan to spend on the project? And do you consider that if you are delayed with something that you want to work in the nights and in the weekends, or will you just level your level of ambition? It's about meetings. How often do you meet? How do you organize your meetings? And what if somebody is late? How do you handle that? And is it okay to be 15 minutes late? Is it okay to be 5 minutes late? Who do you notify and how do you notify if you are late for a meeting? In the organization of meetings, write down if you have a chairman, a referee, do you use the blackboard? Do you keep the minutes in Slack or do you keep it in Google Docs? Or how do you organize the meetings? Also, how does it work if a student in the group wants to have a meeting which was not planned? How do you organize calling for such a meeting? It's also about division of labor. How do you divide the labor? Do you appoint a project manager who is dividing the labor? Do you have a morning meeting every day where you decide who is going to do what today? Or do you just distribute it on a case-by-case basis in agreement with the whole group? So finding out exactly how you divide the labor is important. Otherwise, soon you will have somebody unhappy with the tasks they were given, that they are not fun enough, or they are not intensive enough, or they are too hard. So agreeing on this one beforehand is very important. Also, what kind of response do you give within the group, and to what extent will you socialize together, and when do you socialize together? So do you expect people to be social, or how do you handle that it's not becoming too social? I know that many of the groups that I've been supervising, they had to make specific rules for how much break they would have to make sure that breaks would be 5 minutes or 10 minutes and not sliding into being half an hour or 45 minutes and not really ending and someone started playing computer and what else is happening. So to make sure that you have a good organization of your time, that's important. And these are really basic recommendations. I suggest that you make a contract of collaboration, both with your supervisor and within the group, and that you discuss what themes should be included. You can use this for inspiration. And then I wish you good luck with the project and good luck with the EPIC project. Thank you so much.